Welcome back, and in this first lesson of this series, we're going to step through an exam question similar to what you might experience on the real exam. I want to get you comfortable with how I approach questions and how I select answers, because one of the things which most students struggle with in the exam is time. And so the quicker we can make the process of you interpreting a question and the answers, the quicker you can answer that question and move on to the next. And if we can improve the rate that you answer questions in the exam, it gives you more time and avoids mistakes. So let's jump in and get started straight away. Now, you can approach exam questions in two different ways. You can read the answers first, or you can read the question first. Now, reading the answers first might sound strange, but it's a valid technique that you can use for the more complex exam questions. Now, both of these techniques have their pros and cons, and throughout this set of lessons, I want to demonstrate both ways. In this lesson, we're going to start by using the question first approach. So this is the question that we have. The question is, the Categram application uses an application load balancer, an auto-scaling group, and currently 10 EC2 instances. To ensure cost efficacy, you have been asked to ensure that when average CPU utilization is below 15%, instances are terminated and added when average CPU is above 65%. Which option should you suggest? Now, lengthwise, this is pretty average for the pro-level exam. Some questions are much longer. If you're using the question-first approach, then step number one is to quickly read the question and then perform keyword identification. Because the pro-level exams are as much about comprehension as they are about technical skills, you need to reduce the time required to understand the question and the answers. So this is what I want to focus on in this set of lessons. What you're looking for is to identify words which matter and those which don't. And because questions can have radically different structures, much of this just comes with practice. What we're looking for are the parts of the question which materially impact which answers we might need to select. So let's have a look at how that's done. Now, if you want to just pause the video at this point and have an attempt at identifying which words from this question you think might be useful when it comes to selecting an answer. So go ahead and pause the video now, and when you've done, you can resume and we'll look at it together. Now, whether you've attempted to do this yourself or not, let's take a look at which keywords I identified. Now, I've highlighted in red the main points of the question which jump out to me, and in green, one special point which I wanted to draw your attention to. And for anyone with colour vision deficiency, I've also underlined them to make them easier to identify. Now, what jumps out at me are a few things. First, the Categram application uses an application load balancer, and this suggests that it's scalable and highly available. The fact that it also has an auto-scaling group suggests some level of scalability and automatic provisioning, because an auto-scaling group also means a launch template or launch configuration. So in other words, instance automatic builds. But what's very interesting is that the question lists a static number of instances, and this is interesting because it suggests there's no actual auto-scaling occurring based on load or schedule or any of the other criteria which auto-scaling groups can use. The question then goes on to specifically mention that cost efficacy is important, and that's key because it suggests a cost driver for the solution, and that could influence the answer that we choose. The next set of keywords, average CPU utilization below 15%, meaning instances are terminated, and added when average CPU is above 65%, they all point to some type of scaling using the auto-scaling group. So at this point, we have an idea of what the question is asking us for. It wants a cost-effective solution to scale the Categram application in or out based on average CPU load. So let's now take a look at which answers we have available for this question. The question has a total of 4 answers. Now, some questions have more, so you have to get used to quickly identifying and absorbing information from the answers. Now we need to follow the same process as we did for the question, identifying keywords which might help us to select an appropriate answer. Now, mindful that we've already done this with the question, we can prioritise anything which seems relevant to that question. So if you spot any keywords in the answers which seem to align or link with any keywords you've identified in the question, then perhaps at this point you can prioritise that as a potential answer. So if you want to try this in advance of me showing you what I've identified, then go ahead and pause the video. What we'll do is after you've done your part, you can resume and then we can compare what I found versus what you found. So at this point, whether you attempted to do this or not, these are the keywords which I identified within these answers. Now let's step through these one by one. I want to focus on why I highlighted those keywords as well as why it matters to answering the question. Let's start with the top answer. Now this answer suggests implementing a scheduled scaling policy, and this straight away jumps out as being wrong. The question specifically states CPU values where instances should be added and removed, and a scheduled scaling policy works based on dates and times, not CPU values. The second part of the answer then goes on to talk about the scheduled scaling policy acting based on CPU usage, which isn't valid for scheduled policies. Now this is actually an example of an answer which self-eliminates. Even without ever reading the question, this conflict between the start and end of the answer can be used to show that it's invalid. So I'm going to eliminate this first answer. Now the second answer straight away has the script keyword, and normally this is a big red flag for any exam questions. It's rare that this is ever the right answer for AWS questions. It might well be valid in the real world, but for AWS questions there's generally a preference to use AWS solutions and not scripts. In this case, the answer mentions using a script to report load back to the auto-scaling service, and architecturally this isn't how it works. You don't report usage to the auto-scaling service, and so we can eliminate this as a correct answer. It also mentions target rules, which isn't a thing. There are target tracking scaling policies, but this isn't the same thing. So overall, this is just a bad answer. Now moving on to the third answer, this suggests implementing target tracking scaling policies at 15% and 65%, and immediately this answer eliminates itself. The point of target tracking scaling policies is that you provide a specific value of something, say CPU utilization, and auto-scaling adds or removes instances to keep as close to that value as possible. Adding policies for two percentages for target tracking scaling policies makes no sense, and the answer goes on to say to use an IAM role to provide the policies with permissions to add and remove EC2 instances. And again, this isn't how auto-scaling works. It doesn't use an IAM role. This is another reason to eliminate the answer. And this leaves the final answer as the correct one. But why? The important thing is the why. It's not simply enough to understand which is the right answer, you need to understand the why. Well, this answer suggests using CloudWatch to monitor average CPU levels, and this is something that the product is designed for. So far, so good. Next, simple scaling policies are used within the auto-scaling group to add and remove instances, and this is also valid. So together, both of these do allow us to implement an elastic architecture, which is what we want for this question. But notice how it makes no mention of 15% or 65%. This is a common strategy to try and push you away from the correct answer. Just because something is omitted, it doesn't mean it's not done. The answer states creating simple scaling policies, and in the real world you'd create one of these policies for when CPU utilization is below 15% or above 65%. but just because the answer doesn't explicitly mention them doesn't prevent the answer from still being valid. You need to understand how to read between the lines and identify if anything in a question excludes it as being a correct answer or if the information is simply omitted. And in this case, because all of the other three answers are incorrect because of errors in those answers, we know that the fourth answer is correct. And so I would pick this answer for the exam. Now, I hope that all made sense. If not, watch the video again and don't worry, I have another 9 of these coming up after this one, so you'll get plenty of exam practice. Now, thanks for watching. Go ahead and complete this video, and then when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.